फ्रेंड हाउ आर यू ऑल। आई होप यू ऑल आर फाइन। आई होप दैट यू आर ऑल प्रैक्टिसिंग योर मैक्सम एट होम। स्टूडेंट टूडे आई एम गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू योर चैप्टर 3 एडिशन। स्टूडेंट आई हैव टोल्ड यू सम वर्ड प्रॉब्लम। टूडे आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन सम मोर वर्ड प्रॉब्लम विच इज गिवन इन योर बुक। So it is given in page number 42 in your maths book. So student, I am taking some problems and explaining you. It is given there are three cows in one field. How many cows are there in one field? There are three cows in one field and two more in another field. So what we have to do in this question, student? We have to find how many cows are there in all. Student, it is given that there are three cows in one field. How many cows are there in first field? In one field there are three cows, and in the second field how many cows are there? Two cows. So in this we have to find how many total cows are there. So in the box is given, you have to write there. In first box you will write 3, in the second box you will write 2. Now we have to count 3 plus 2. How much is 3 plus 2? So for counting we will draw strokes. So first number is 3, 1, 2, 3, then sign of addition, then it is 2, 1, 2. So how much is total? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So how much is total? 3 plus 2, how much is total, student? 3 plus 2 is 5. It is given there are 3 cows in one field, 2 more in another field. So in total you have to find how many cows are there. So 3 plus 2 is 5. I hope, student, you have understood this, sir. I am taking one more example to explain you. Student, you have to read this question. So please read this question at your home. Ramesh, next question is, Ramesh brought 6 apples and Sita brought 3 apples to school. So it is given Ramesh is a boy. He has brought how many apples to the school? 6. And Sita is a girl. She has brought how many apples? 3 apples to school. So we have to tell how many apples did they bring. Means we have to tell total how many apples they have bring. So we will write first number which is given. It is given 6. So we will write here 6. Sign of addition is given. Next is 3. So adding 6 and 3 we will draw lines. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. First number is 6. So I have drawn 6 lines. For addition we are putting the sign of plus. Next is 3. 1, 2, 3. Now we will count all together how much it is. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. How much is 6 plus 3, student? It is 9. So how much apple they brought to the school? It is 9. Student, I hope you all have understood this sum also. I am taking one more word problem from your book to explain you. There are 5 birds in one branch. It is given there are 5 birds on one branch. How many birds are there in one branch, student? There are 5 birds in one branch and 4 birds on the other. And on the other, how much birds are there? 4. Now we have to tell how many birds are there on two branches. Now student, the question is, there are how many birds in first branch? It is 5. And there is another branch, how many birds are there? 4. So you have to tell all together how many birds are there. So student, first we will write here 5, next 4. Now we will do total. So for this we will count, draw the lines. First number is 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Addition plus next is 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now we will count all together, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. How much is 4 plus 5 plus 4? It is 9. So there are 9 birds in 2 branches. Student, please read the question before doing the sum. You have to read the question and do the sum. And next, I have explained in addition in this chapter how to add the number. Suppose it is given 4 plus 3. So how will you add this 4 plus 3? Student, tell me how will you add? First, we will draw how much line? We will draw 4 lines. 1, 2, 3, 4. Next, for the sign of addition, plus. Next number is 3. So how many lines we will draw? 3. So in total, how much it is? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. How much is, student? 4 plus 3? It is 7. Next, student, I am taking one more example. It is 6 plus 2. So student, how much line we will draw first? We will draw 6 line. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Next is 2. 1, 2. Now total, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. How much is 6 plus 2, student? 8. Now student, I am going to tell you some properties of additions. Some properties of addition. Some properties of addition. Suppose student, you are given a number, you have to add 1 to it. Suppose I am taking 2-3 examples all together so that you are able to understand it clearly. Suppose we are given a number and we have to add 1. Here it is 4 plus 1, here it is 3 plus 1, here it is 2 plus 1, here it is 5 plus 1. If we are adding 1 to any number, if we are adding 1 to any number, then we are getting the next number. Means 4 plus 1, without counting, you can tell 4 plus 1. The number is 4. In 4, we are adding 1. So what we will get? We will get the next number. So after 4, which number is coming? 5. So we can write directly 5. Next is 3 plus 1. If you are adding 1 and 3, the number is 3. We are adding 1, so we will get the next number of 3. Which is coming next to 3? It is 4. Without counting, you can write directly. Now 2 plus 1. So we are adding 1 into, so which is the number next to 2? It is 3. So we will write 3. 5 plus 1, 6. 6 plus 1, if it is given 6 plus 1, after 6, which number is coming? 7. We can write directly 7. If it is 7 plus 1, which number is coming after 7? We will write 8. If it is 8 plus 1, then 9. If it is 9 plus 1, then it will be 10. If we are adding 1 to any number, we will get the next number. If we are adding 1 to any number, we will get the next number. This is one of the property of addition, student. Now I am telling one more property. Suppose if you are adding 0, I have told you about 0 na? 0, Z-E-R-O, 0, we are writing 0 like this. This is 0. If we are adding 0 to any number, suppose I have taken 3, if I am adding 0 to 3, I will get the same number. I will get the same number. Next, I have taken 4 plus 0. So, I will get the 4 itself. Because 0 means, what do you mean by 0? 0 means nothing. What do you mean by 0? I have told you na, 0 means Nothing. Suppose it is 5 plus 0, then we will get the 5 itself. If it is 6 plus 0, then we will get the 6 itself. Means if we are adding 0 to any number, we will get the same number. And if we are adding 1 to any number, then we will get the next number. If we are adding 1 to any number, we will get the next number. And if we are adding 0, then we will get the same number. These are the two properties of addition which you should know. First, if we are adding 0, then we will get the same number. If we are adding 1, we will get the next number. Student, I hope you have all understood this chapter, addition. Please do practice and read the questions of the word problem which is given in your book. Thank you for today.